Hello, I'm Aaron Hampton with EOTECH, and now that you've bought your new Vudu scope, we're going to go over ring and mount selection. First thing we want to do when we get ready to mount, just for safety's sake, I'm going to go ahead and pull the bolt and visually and physically check the chamber, make sure that it's clear. Next up, we want to set our rings on the rifle so that we get the proper spacing. And keep in mind, I'm going to be taking these off in a minute, so I really just want to make sure the spacing is right. And what I try to look at is make sure that I'm not obstructing the ejection port. I'm going to take our scope, place it inside the saddle. Now, what's important here is that we make sure that there's more than an ample room. One, for the objective lens to clear the barrel. We don't want it touching at all. Two, that our turrets are able to be accessed from either side. And third, we want to make sure that when we adjust our magnification, the eyepiece is not contacting the base. Once we've ensured this, we're gonna get behind the rifle, shoulder it up, and get a good cheek weld. And I'm gonna move this scope back and forth until I get the entire optical image inside. I don't want any shading around the edges or the inside. I want that image to fill the entire eye box. So right about here is about perfect for me. All I'm looking for right now is to ensure that those checks 1, 2, and 3, my objective, my turrets have access, and my eyepiece is clear, and that I maintain that proper eye relief. At this point, I'm going to lightly attach. What I want to do is snug it down just enough so that I'm not moving the scope around, but I want to be able to rotate it so that once we get to our next step, we can find true level. We're going to go ahead and remove our scope and ring. One of the most important things when you start talking about long range shooting is that the reticle and that scope are properly level. I just have a simple speed square. So we take that speed square, bump it right up against the edge of our capped windage turret, and all I'm going to do is rotate that scope just until I can see no gapping. Now, all I have to do, hold my scope tight. You'll be in the neighborhood of 18 to 21 inch pounds. So once we've done that, we come back and check level again. Boom, we nailed it. Now we can mount it back up on our rifle. All right, so now that we've got our scope mounted back up, got great ease of movement, no contact points. Reticle looks extremely level. Now we're ready to bore sight and get out to the range. When we're using a one-part base, we don't have to start off on the rifle's Picatinny rail because we know that it's set up to fit on that rail. But we still have to place that mount in our preferred location on that firearm and then get our proper eye relief. Once we've achieved the proper eye relief, we're going to do exactly the same thing on this particular mount. Each cap is engraved. So we do want to make sure that we put the same cap on and line those up. Once we've got our cap set, I like to go ahead and mount them on a flat base piece of Picatinny rail that I have. And I do the exact same thing with our speed square. Go ahead and use it to get it nice and level. Keep in mind that the important thing when you're mounting your Vudu rifle scope is that it's not in contact with anything on the firearm other than the rings of the base, and most importantly, it's got to be level. Once we've leveled it all out, again, we want to bore sight so that we're close to on paper, and then the only way to get a true zero is to get out to the range.